Alright. How are we doing, Chris Brown? We gotta get some way to, I know they give those stadiums, the sports people, those noisemakers, those noise, this new mic stand, it's great. I really gotta tighten it though. I've already gone for a few shows where this thing does not listen to me. It's hilarious. It's like a puppy, you know? They're so cute and disobedient, you know? It's like, stop it. This little mic, because I haven't had a mic stand for a very long time. Just like a lot of us haven't had a puppy for a very long time, you know? This is just like your average regular reminder that there's stuff you can do here every day of the week. And there's your weekly schedule for just that stuff, you know? You see Mondays, that keeps projecting again. You know, tomorrow night, 8-ball tournament. Let's see what we got tonight, folks. This is Pete's projecting again.
Yeah!
Yeah! I'm doing it. I'm projecting. This is going to be fun. We're going to develop troops. I wanted to make sure we have some constants going on for this, because this isn't going to stop. It's like a train, you know, that breaks. And those are dangerous, but fun to watch. And that's exactly what tonight will be like. Dangerous and fun to watch. Thank you, Chris Plouch, for having us out here and always just being so very supportive when I do my events. I couldn't do any of these without them, and it's amazing. Thank you. You are at Pete's Projecting again. Boom, boom, boom. Subscribe on Patreon. Send healing vibes to Pierce. We were thinking about that, you know. Pierce could use some healing vibes. He's been out here to do a bunch of our comedy stuff. He could use some healing vibes on a Christmas morning. another thing, Kabir Singh is coming out this Friday. You've seen him on America's Got Talent, Comedy Central, Dry Bar Comedy, and Family Guy. Now he's going to be here at the Chris Lounge, $10, bring a friend, because, you know, who knows how many people will show up. I need as many people as possible. And if people don't show up, this guy's famous as hell, and he'll remember not to come back, and he'll tell other famous people, so... I'm just saying, if you have a cardboard cutout from your favorite fantasy movie, bring it in and just throw it in the back, you know? I remember FYE would have those big life-size Deadpools, you know, in the mall for quite a while. I'll lend you my dolly. Kabir Singh's awesome. Look him up on Google. I can't wait to have him out. We're going to begin our first section back by popular demand. Back by popular demand. Hell yeah, that's the spirit. Pete's projecting again. If you guys haven't been listening to the morning show that I do on Humble Pot Air, there's also that, and it's a similar format. Fun stuff, random content. Back by popular demand, my New Year's low resolution. I don't know, I think that thing should just stick around. That thing is a work of art. The New Year's low resolution. Back by popular demand. Back by popular demand. It's raining way too much again. It's what you guys wanted. You say, oh, I love the rain. Now look at this place, you know? Look at all the rain. My feet are soaked. I heard thunder last night. There's not thunder often here. There's water everywhere.
It's pouring right now.
I have to pay.
It is, isn't it? It is.
Oh, no wonder. No one's here at the show because everyone said, oh, I want it to rain. We're already in a temperate rainforest climate. It's already gonna rain. Everyone's just like, loves the rain so much, it makes the rain more, you know? Back by popular demand. Supply shortages correspond with popularity and demand. It's economics, it's literally math. So backed by popular demand, anything that is backed by popular demand comes with a supply shortage. So if you're doing any second level college economics courses, you could have a demand curve and a supply curve, and they come down like this, depending on the amount. You guys get it. You guys get it. Supply shortages come with popular demand. Backed by popular demand, tonight we're going to have Melting Vision coming up at the end of the show. It's going to be amazing. If you don't listen to his show on Humboldt Hot Air, you can listen in Sundays at 1, humboldthotair.org. Backed by popular demand, we got Melting Vision. Fuck yeah. It is exciting because you're going to see this event just develop so much over time. You're going to go, oh my God. Because we got like this whole psytrance scene is just going to start here. And we're going to get this place open past 10. You know? We're going to fill this place with works. So many works paying like $50 a ticket, you know? Take a look at that one. In the future, less people will be in our way at Planet Fitness, you know? Because it's still January. I did this one last week, actually. I had to update it. Because things got way worse since last week. In the future, less people will be in your way at the breadline. Yeah, so update, you know, a little topical about how this year's going so far. In the future, your friend needs an edible. Don't forget to pick up edibles today. I think edibles are on sale today. This is the Edible Monday. Munchy Monday. 10% off edibles. In the future, your friend needs an edible. I've been, like, really into the drinks here, but that's just because, like, I don't know. This is California Sober Central. This is the Mecca for people who want to be able to have a life where you don't have drunk people breathing in your face, like inches away, yelling their life story that you never asked them, you know? In the future, your friend needs an edible on Munchy Monday. Weed trivia time. Isn't this great? We got a template going. Hell yeah. This is awesome. You're the best. I love the enthusiasm. People will know. This will be a cult in 4 months. Just watch. Weed trivia. How old is weed? Ooh. What? How old is weed? Anyone, shout it out.
420 years old.
That's a good guess.
4.20 million.
Melting Vision.
Old.
Alright guys. I looked it up. I did the research. 2,500 years old. They smoked it in the pair in the autocorrect, screw me on this one. The Pajir Mountains. They smoked it in the Pajir Mountains in western China. True story. That was the first time that weed was used to get high, basically, according to one website that I found online, so you know that's gotta be a fact. let's another question. There are about 100 cannabinoids in the marijuana plant. There are about 100 cannabinoids in the marijuana plant. That's the question. The answer? There are about 100 cannabinoids in the marijuana plant. So, weed trivia. I really do. Oh my God. What is the largest producer? Next question. There we go. Next question. What's the largest producer of marijuana in the world? What country? I'll clarify. What country is the largest producer of marijuana in the world? Aren't these questions, I feel like they're questions we should know the answers to. This is like how they don't teach you about insurance in high school, you know? They don't teach you how to do your taxes. They just, you know? They keep you from knowing what you really want to know, which is what countries have the most weed. Well, I mean, and I know why. It's because we would move them, you know? Any guesses? What's the country that produces the most weed in the world?
Humboldt County.
Could you imagine? How are they doing this on an international level?
What is Humboldt County?
is Humboldt County? Any other guesses? It's a country.
Jamaica.
Jamaica. That would be amazing. I wonder what.
Mexico.
There we go. Thank you so much, Dean.
Mexico.
Let's hear the answer is Morocco. Morocco, for centuries, has been exporting hashish, and they accounted for 11% of global cannabis export. All right, guys. One more question. Did you know that Shakespeare smoked weed? It's true. He got high. Did you know? That's the question. Let's see what the answer is. You now know that Shakespeare smoked weed. That's your answer. He did. Is this the most like intellectual evening you've ever been to? It's cool, you know? People just don't know.
We got some
people that don't like getting wet, which makes that one joke that I talked about the rain being annoying more funny. I was right. They still didn't laugh while they were here, but now that they're not here, it's like even less laughter somehow. Upcoming shows at the Crisp. I'm gonna go straight through these real fast, but we got open mic comedy every Thursday at 8. That's the flyer for it. I'm proud of it because I changed their joint to a microphone. That's a work of art. Did it on my phone. Kara Smokey every Wednesday at 7 p.m. We're looking for big crowds of people ready to have fun because we've been singing so much lately and I love it and it's so fun. You got to be there to understand why I'm like going on about it. It's so fun. You channel energy through your throat chakra when you sing. It's amazing. Sunday nights at 6:30, we have a local musician, Tim Tripp, coming out with a lot of his friends to do open mic. It's a general poetry or music open mic, though some comedy occasionally may happen at it as well. And that's every Sunday night at 6:30. You are at Pete's Projecting again, which is Mondays at 7. It's fun, you know? I am a projection kind of person. This is Friday. Friday we got Kabir Singh. We were talking about that earlier, but now you can see what he looks like, you know? And it's what the little Canva template did for me. Isn't that a nice template? Thank you. That's gonna be this Friday. And then Saturday, so Eleanor Ryan is gonna be opening for Kabir Singh. She's a Portland comic known for her, she goes by the brand name of the Hood Skank. She's a Hood Skank comedian. We'll figure out what she means by that when she gets down here. But she's hilarious. I saw her up in Medford, and I had to get her down here. So we actually have her for Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And then she's gonna be headlining Saturday and Sunday. So it's double shows. If you like her one night, come back and tell your friends. She's gonna be hilarious. I can't wait for that one. But, you know, enough with the commercial break. We are on to breaking news.
Yeah!
Breaking news, guys. You guys ready for breaking news? This is actually some of you guys' favorite part of the evening, right?
Fuck yeah!
It's the breaking news. We haven't seen it yet. I'll let the tension build. Do you guys think I'm just gonna do the same shit as last week? Do you really think it would leave us all hanging? Do you think that maybe there's some fun new shit in the breaking news period portion thing? Dude, this is breaking news. If I fuck up breaking news, everyone's gonna hate me, you know? Here, I'm gonna do a breaking news column. No, it's boring. That's our featured comedian, Amanda Crisp. Breaking news, Rio Del Man proposes to his longtime girlfriend.
Last week, a truck got pregnant for him.
Yeah, this week. You can tell the stump's a girl.
By the bean?
Missing. My weed pen has come up missing. There is a search going on for it. There are groups being formed, people being contacted. This is a serious deal. It was a brand new weed pen. It tasted great. I got like four rips off of it. And then this guy borrowed it and then said he gave it back to me. And he did it. And I was like, dude, have to give me my weed pen. And he said, I gave it back to you. I said, no, you didn't give it back to me. You have to give me that. And he said, I'll go look for it, but I'm so sure I gave it back to you. He didn't. He did not give it back to me. And so then he left without telling me he was leaving, right? So that's a little telling. I just had my weed pen sold by this guy, right? Is it missing? If I know someone took it, what is, I found it. That's why they call it Eureka. There's a bunch of stolen shit here. Eureka, I found it. It's stolen, you know, and I'm glad I found it. Someone stole this from me, you know? We're at the pawn shop across the street. Can you bring your weed pen to a pawn shop and get like at least $5 for it from the dude? Why wouldn't you? It's a pawn shop. Are these things suddenly valueless? Give me my weed pen back, whoever you are. I want my weed pen back. It's missing. James Webb Telescope discovers a planet with long Rasta dreads. It has been discovered. It's rad. It's the coolest planet you have seen in your life. I mean, when are they gonna just find everything else like this in the universe? We sent a contact probe full of weed. It looks like it's down to party. It's like a party planet. You've heard of Planet Fitness, so this is Planet Rasta Dreads. They work out sometimes, you know? Definitely. James Webb Telescope discovers a planet with long Rasta dreads. Look at that Photoshop. That's just such a happy looking planet, you know? Also, breaking news, all entrances to McKinleyville are closed because some dude put cones in front of them. It's really easy to find cones because he just pick them up off the side of the
Eureka.
Road.
Eureka!
Someone else, some guy, you know, you can't get to McKinleyville, but people are obeying all the cones, so that's why cones work like that. They're kind of the only thing that you don't question, and people have been circling all day. Because some dude moved some cones around and made the exits all closed. Huge traffic. There's horses. There's a line of horses wrapped around the town. President Biden declares war on Rasta Planet. Oh no! He's gonna use the Space Force against the Rasta Planet. This guy's really. What a president, huh? How could you, President Biden? What lives on the Rasta planet? Do you think that the dreadlocks have like certain species and then the rest of the planet? Yeah, Rasta planet. This is the most amazing thing I've ever seen. That was breaking news.
I love breaking news.
Isn't it fun? If you like breaking news, you can listen to me on the Ooh Friday mornings from 7 to 9. Or at any time of day, if you use the archives, it's really easy to find it on the website. You just type in 7, and then whatever the most recent Friday was, you can get my show. It's great for when you're looking for something to listen to. And then also, all the Humboldt Hot Air shows are really good. Don't just listen for mine specifically. You can listen to it live. And there's like 40 volunteers just always DJing. Sam's one of them. He's got an amazing show. They're so vibrant. It's such a spectrum of shows. I love it. I did 2 slides for that. So I'll just reiterate it, guys. But there's all your stuff. I think it feels like I skipped. No, I know what that was. I am all done with my part of the night. We're going to bring on Psytrance artist Melting Vision.
Hell yeah, Sam!
Oh, yeah. If you haven't seen him before, he's a treat.
Hi, Sam.
Maybe a minute or two to get you set up. Dude, I'm always so high when we're doing this. I didn't even know. Oh, I didn't even use the didgeridoo. I'm going to play with the didgeridoo. All right, I had one didgeridoo joke to do while Sam's setting up. Why was the Aborigine held back 1 year in high school?
Why?
Because he didn't didgeridoo his own homework. That's the whole joke. That was all right.
Do the thing.
Thank the didgeridoo?
Yeah, that thing.
Thank you. Thank you. know that when I have this song in the dumps, that I'm successful out there. They call this God's music.
Thank you. clean endings. That's great. Epic. Thank you, Sam.
Thank you guys so much for listening.
It was great.
Amazing. Amazeballs.
I was just talking to my doctor today, and I was like, yeah, I can't hear that well. And they're like, do you listen to a lot of live music events? And I'm like, sitting there pausing for a really long time. I wear earplugs, is what I said. I wear earplugs. Fuck you. Get out of my head.
Dude, Peter, you would love this. And some of the parties in the last year, there's a guy that'll just camp out, like he'll put his sleeping bag right next to the speakers, and he'll just get huddled.
Yeah,
and
he's
like, not move. You've seen this guy, okay? And then, like, it's just like
I haven't seen the guy he's talking about specifically, but I've seen people like.
it's just like fucking.
Have you seen like the fools that look like speaker lizards? People that like crawl in the fucking speaker.
Oh, it's obscene, dude.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, you have to wonder like how they're hearing.
Talking about getting like Ocean or Ocean Grove and Trinidad and those cabins.
Oh,
every opportunity possible to just like wrap and expose all these people and be like, hey, by the way, this is here.
Yeah.
It's a movement.
Yeah, yeah.
We now know that Shakespeare smoked weed.
Yeah, that was fun. Did you make that photo?
I know someone else did.
Okay, so that was good.
Yeah, that's so funny.
The fucking eyes look like you like did it after the fact.
So you know how I taint all the photos blue? Those are like deep red eyes in the real photo.
Oh, word, okay. Okay.
Tech people, invite collaborator, melting vision.
Subject here.